Next speaker for the day is Renuka Ganesh, General Manager HRD from Biocon. A very warm welcome to you, Renuka.
Thank you. I'll just share my screen.
Absolutely.
So I represent Biocon, and I'll be happy to share a couple of programs that we have done, which is kind of long drawn, and I'm specifically focusing on the women leadership development program. Just to understand the landscape we're operating in, it's important to know what we do at Biocon. Most of you would be aware that Biocon is a global pharmaceutical company, and has been changing lives in over more than 120 countries. We've been the pioneer in biotechnology, and this is our 44th year, and we are heading strong. We have a clear goal to give patients worldwide access to innovative and affordable healthcare. These are the key words for us. It needs to be affordable, it needs to be accessible, and innovation is the core of our business. Our R&D forms the bedrock of Biocon's mission to deliver affordable therapeutics that addresses unmet patient needs while maintaining the highest standards of quality. Our people fuel innovation in our pipeline and hold true to our commitment of exploring the unexplored in medicines. And this is our core focus, and what we think makes us very different, or in fact, any pharma industry, is the kind of workforce that we have. The diversity in the workforce is our strength. And why I say so is that we have people from different geographies, different regions, religions, age groups, experiences. All of these diverse experiences and perspectives actually nurture our culture of innovation. And this helps us with coming out with novel products and novel solutions to the healthcare challenges. And one such step that we had taken in about 2017 is to create this forum for women, which we call as BioWin, the Biocon Women's Initiative. This forum is created to dedicate, to have specific initiatives that are aimed at nurturing women's talent in the organization and achieving our goal on increasing the diversity ratios. So given that we are right from manufacturing to quality to sales to, product development to research to, research services. So we have a variety of population that is working with us. Some of these fields are not, are yet to be explored by women in terms of, the exposure. For example, in the manufacturing setup, we wouldn't find too many women leaders who are at the helm of affairs. And thereby, when you see our diversity snapshot, our overall ratio of women is 14%, but when you see research services, it's about 40%. And that clearly reflects the differential in women's talent pool as far as the industry is concerned. And therefore, we have an uphill task in doing what it takes to improve that ratio. So one of the things that BioWin as a forum initiated was this forum itself, where specific initiatives were launched, which aimed at addressing women's needs, addressing women's challenges, providing a platform for employees, women employees, to share and resolve their issues, either amongst themselves or amongst peers. Though it is a forum for women and by the women, there are many occasions on which the entire organization comes together to make things happen and help programs in this, driven through this forum to succeed. So one of the things is, for example, is our talent acquisition focus. I mean, in the previous talk, I was just focusing on some of the aspects about, developing women right from the entry level to right up to their progression in the organization. one of the initial steps that we have taken, or one of the first steps that we felt was important, is to consciously focus on women hiring rate. And there are specific initiatives that we have done at the talent acquisition stage where we are consciously focusing on the ratio of women that are getting hired, and to be able to provide more opportunities for the women who are already applying for the roles in Biocon. And we clearly we see that that rate has increased. If we see in the last 3 years, it's increased by 5%, and we are heading strong because we have a clear goal from the organization, from the top, to have a higher ratio of women at across levels. And given that there is top commitment, then acquisition rates are definitely going to go higher. One of the other things that we did is rolling out a referral program that is lucrative when you refer a woman employee. And we roll out these programs specifically to encourage a larger women's workforce in our population. One of the things that we did is, to track how many women employees attrited. And it's interesting to see that our attrition has come down by 5% in the last 3 years for women employees, and that we were deliberating and seeing, which are the programs that have actually helped. One key program which we saw was a significant impact was the opportunities that have been provided, which I talk about on, women's training and training women to take up larger roles and specific development programs for women leaders. And the other aspect that we saw a clear ratio which has increased was that our creche facility, which we had, we had changed the way it was operating, and we saw 200% increase in the, utility of the creche facility, which basically means that a working mother is stress-free and she has no worries. She's able to leave her child without having to worry about the safety and development and growth of her child, because it goes right up to 6 years and the child is also taught in the creche. So that was a significant ratio, significant increase in the usage of the creche facility, which talks volumes about the facility itself. I'll move on to the program specifically. So there was a women's leadership development program, which we called as Women in Leadership Program, which was for senior women in the senior managerial roles in the organization. Like I said earlier, we do not have a huge women's population working for many years in the manufacturing sector. And therefore, the ratio of women that are available in the top leadership positions are relatively lower. And this program was specifically aimed at the senior people already working in the senior managerial roles. And one of the thoughts that came up was to see how we could nurture this talent to take up leadership roles. And we developed an 18-month program. And this was a mix. It was a good blend of classroom training. It was peer learning. We had a, learning, action learning program or a project with experiential learning. I will talk a little more about the depths of this program. So the program started with identifying all the top leaders, top women leaders, and creating a program specifically for women. So most organizations have a leadership development program. Now here we culled out the women leaders because there was a specific need that needed to be required to be addressed. So one of the aspects that we brought into the curriculum was a specific focus on the career advancement of women leaders. So that session was something that was kind of an eye opener for most of the women. There was another session which we brought in, which was on the behavioral aspects of the mind of people and how the mind works, how that can be leveraged to influence and negotiate in those leadership roles. And like, you know, Verizon also mentioned, the financial business acumen is, of course, an important aspect for any leader, irrespective of gender. And so there was a specific session that we did around that. All of these sessions, including business strategy, developing financial acumen, behavioral skills and coaching, and career advancement of women leaders, these were conducted at IIM in their premises for all the senior leaders. And this was spanned around 3 to 4 months. And we concluded that part of the session with an action learning project. So the action learning project was very specific to the company. So everybody had a mentor, one from IIM and one from the company itself. So the senior leaders volunteered to be the mentors for all of these team members. And each of the leaders took up a specific project, which was a live project, and it was not in their department. So they had to pick up a cross-functional project and work on it. So this was, throwing a challenge to most of these leaders, because all of them were experts in what they did best. And this was kind of pushing them out of their comfort zone and opening up new challenges for them. So most of them, almost everybody, have acknowledged that this exposure gave them a lot of learning. And this action learning project has, spread over at least 3 months, 3 to 6 months. And then it concluded with a project presentation. So there were clear deliverables that were expected out of these projects. They were live projects. So they had to conclude with an actionable. And the actionable had to be accepted by the mentor in whose team this project was delivered, or if it was multiple leaders, all of them would have to review, brainstorm, and agree that the project has concluded with the desirable results. Once that was done, this was presented back to the IIM faculty, as well as the internal leadership team, which included the CEO. And they were, it was like an assessment. It was like a viva. So everyone went through their presentations on the project, their learning, what is the outcome and what is the effectiveness of that project. And proof in the pudding lies when, these projects are actually implemented after the actual ALP is done. And we see that a lot of these projects are taken forward by the respective teams thereafter. So the entire groundwork which was done in the first 6 months by these women was then with clear actionables handed over to the execution team, and they have taken it forward. So that is one of the measures of success of this program. After doing this, we did not want to leave it just like that, and we wanted a specific continuity to the programs. Now, one other aspect that we had done just before we started this program was we had told all the women leaders to write down their personal leadership goal and their vision and their individual IDP for achieving those visions. Now, at the end of this project, we told them to revisit that. And when they revisited that, there was far more clarity on what exactly was their leadership vision and how exactly they would be moving ahead. This was further supplemented with a 360-degree feedback. We did a 360-degree feedback on each of them individually and gave them all their respective reports, which really helped them, take on the next phase, which was a mentoring. So the mentoring was with the senior leaders in the organization. They could choose their mentor, and they would go through the mentorship. One of the base documents or references for them to fall back on was the 360-degree feedback, which was like a mirror, and they could discuss with their mentor on what aspects they had to work on and how do they go about some of the work-related challenges or individual challenges. So this 8-month mentorship program, and they were aligned not to their managers, but to their cross-functional leaders. So this gave a lot of both visibility as well as you know, exposure to them in terms of, you know, cross-functional interactions, and also get learning from people who they may or may not have interacted with beyond work, right? So this was the 18-month program, and you know, some of these people have now taken on leadership roles and are doing very well in the organization. So we see, as the opportunities are going to come up, this pool will be the pool that will take on the reins of those roles. And what more to say than, you know, we being led by Dr. Kiran Majumdar Shaw. So she gives us all the inspiration as to what we can aspire for. So given this, we wanted to look at the next part of this program, which is the next level of women, right? So we have the middle management women who are now aspiring to be women leaders. So we looked at two opportunities. One was the you know, mentoring program with CII, which is a cross-industry mentoring. So some of the women leaders were nominated to be mentored by experts from beyond the company. So this was across an industry. So this is a new exposure, and you know, it's a neutral ground. So there are no inhibitions, and people could you know, volunteer and get to this platform and leverage this platform to enhance their capabilities as leaders. The other program that you know, is was opened up was the leapfrog program. This is for the upcoming women leaders, and this is about 8 to 10 months. This is still going on, and you know, there are many women leaders who have been nominated for that. So this is the middle management women leaders, and the focus is very different over here. However, the point is that the organization has taken cognizance of the need to specifically look at women leadership development and has put in specific programs to nurture this talent, as we know that this is the talent that can contribute immensely to the growth of the organization. So there was another initiative that was rolled out this year, which is the leadership potential assessment, which was done. You know, document that kind of is left with the leaders to introspect and see what are the leadership competencies that are expected by the organization, and where does the individual fare on these competencies, and what is the you know, what is the action plan that they have to take thereafter. We have also provided a mentoring platform, which is an in-house mentoring opportunity. So women who choose to look at women internal mentors can opt for mentors. And this is, you know, across the company, across functions, they could choose, they could reach out to people who are certified as mentors, and they would be able to take their action learning programs or plans to a logical conclusion, and they will be able to work on their development needs. There's also a quarterly women's dialogue forum that is opened up. Now, this is where there are, you know, there are speakers from either inside within Biocon, outside of Biocon. There are experts from the industry who are invited to speak, and it's a level playground. So most women feel comfortable to talk about the specific issues that are brought up in this forum. So there are very specific, the discussion forums are with a specific agenda. And you know, anybody who's interested in discussing that agenda are invited, are welcome to attend the session. And since we have experts who are available to answer these questions, so this forum has proved to be very successful in the organization, where a lot of women employees feel the use of leveraging this kind of a capability and talent. And they come out to these forums and have an open, candid conversation, which leaves them with questions answered, and what more if they can have questions answered and take it forward to the next step. The next other platform that we have provided to all employees, in fact, is an app which is available on their mobile, on their laptop. They can access from anywhere, which is related to wellness. Now, there are specific programs which are done. Now, we're talking of women leadership. Now, one of the softer aspects of women leaders is the kind of dynamics that they're working in. As a society, the kind of pressures, the family, the society, the industry, there are various aspects that a woman has to deal with. Now, some of these aspects are tailored and addressed through these apps. The app is specifically, we call it BioPulse, and this app is aimed at looking at wellness, employee wellness. Now, some of the things that we do specifically, which where we see a lot of traction with women, is around counseling, is around women's health, is around childcare, is around social well-being, mental well-being of both individual and family. Is about in the pandemic situation, we did look at sessions that were around home remedies and looking at how you could perform better from home. What are the ergonomics that you could take care of to be able to stay fit? How do you stay fit at home? And this app also has recorded videos which could be looked at any point in time. And there are those videos are for physical fitness. So you could choose whether you want to do a Zumba or yoga or, just dance or meditate. All of that was available. So you just choose the option you want. You do it at your own time. Your entire family can avail this benefit. And what we believe is all of this contributes to an employee who is able to contribute better to the organization because we are taking care of these aspects that otherwise play on their mind. So these are the various things that we have specifically done with respect to women leadership. And we believe that, I also already mentioned that some of them have taken up senior leadership roles, and we would like to look at more and more women taking up those roles while we have made so many focused efforts with respect to the training and development programs. We see a lot of them who are keenly participating in these programs, and as an organization, we have the commitment that we would provide these opportunities. So when we have developed them, we provide the opportunities. There's no looking back on the numbers.
Thank you so much, Renuka. It was a pleasure having you here.